Big truck.
Thank you.
lot of it. But I know I feel really fortunate to play on this historic day. And something that will change my life, I think. Okay, this is one of our own songs. It's called Fountain of Youth. It's about the youth of today, the now generation, and how we must make a difference, because it's only good for us left.
Let's stay alive. to stop and think about the things that we can do individually.
We have a guest speaker now who's going to speak on animal rights, June Mathis.
I take it, and when I'm getting dressed ready to go, I listen to my I take, and verily I can come through and do my job. However, I wrote the speech, I haven't had time to read it. So I cannot read it to you right now. What is animal rights? They were given none. What are human rights? To live a normal, healthy life with liberty and humanity, which we gave ourselves. What is the animal rights movement? It is the awakening of our inner conscience of the sad treatment of animals that exist. What can we do about it? Well, let me first ask you if you know these following things exist. We use and abuse animals for entertainment. We wear them, we eat them, we trap them, shoot them, breed them for our wants. We make them work overtime, and when we have no further use for them, we sell them, we trade them, and we even kill them. Excuse me, I have a cold on top of everything else. Let's take an easy subject to start off with, our house pets. There's a right way and a wrong way to train your pet. Housebreaking a puppy, for instance, the wrong way is to reprimand the puppy, rub his nose in it, and expect that is when he goes potty the house as often. Now what you've done with that puppy, you have made him afraid of going, not where he is going. Do you understand the difference? The right way, of course, is to take your puppy out every 2 to 3 hours and praise him when he does go out and even give him a treat. Remember, you can catch more flies with honey than you can with vinegar. For instance, I train dogs with a come-along method. It's a halter that fits over the face of the dog and not only enables the trainer to start at a very young age of 4 months, but it teaches the dog in canine language instead of human methods of choke chains, pinch collars, shock collars. It not only injures the animal, but forces it in our human macho way of saying, you do, or you know, you do as I tell you, or else. The animal is threatened and obeys because it's scared not to, and its neck is too painful to resist that command again. I know, I used to train dogs that way. But Dr. DeGroot, a veterinarian, who saw the injuries on her patients, developed the halter method, as she says, would you train a horse with a choke chain? Dr. DeGroot is an animal behaviorist, an animal psychologist, and I'm proud to be her friend. I'm proud to teach her method. With this method, I can stop dogs biting, fighting, by using her method of desensitizing. A gentle canine method, dogs understand the body language. Once we learn it, we can overcome just about any kind of problem. Killing exquisite animals like leopards, coyotes, foxes, martens, mink, sables, seals, raccoons, deer, and oh yes, rabbits, or for furs to wear on your backs. You are very aware of the cruelty because the media has done a wonderful job covering our movements, exposing the cruelty of hundreds of thousands of animals dying in agony in traps, not to mention people's dogs that happen to be walking by. The fires have lost, but the animals are still in danger because of the black market. If you love animals, don't wear fur coats. Besides, it's passé, and wearing faux fur does not hurt any living creature, and it's always a compliment to be copied. Research labs that work on animals for cosmetics, shameful. Absolutely outrageous. Rabbit heads stuck in stocks. Do you know what the stock is? A rabbit needs to put on top of another one and the animal is held by its neck. It cannot move. Their eyes are used for testing eyeshadow, mascara, even hair dyes. Rabbits, mice, and rats continue are tested with all cosmetics, even sunscreens, suntan lotions, shaving creams, and even rabbit skins have been burnt to see if these actually, lotions will work, and also using them anti-perspirant on them. If you love animals, buy products that are not tested on animals by cosmetics and household products. They have a tremendous selection now. You'll find them in your health food stores. Eating dogs and cats in some countries is not only a delicacy, but an everyday occurrence. Oh yes, I know, you're quite horrified. What difference is there in eating lambs, rabbits, pigs, baby beef, little calves, you know, veal? There is no difference. The only difference is the victim. Look at the way they kill the cats and dogs, you're going to say. Yes, and indeed, sad, but go to the slaughterhouse and see how they kill steer, pigs, lambs, and chickens, and then tell me what is the difference, and I repeat, there's no difference but the victim. If you love animals, give up eating them. Regards to birds, macaws were shot down from trees to obtain their tail feathers because of the same behavior of human vanity. The birds that flew in masses at the turn of the century are now extinct or close to extinction. Today, the green-winged macaw is on the endangered list with many others. We don't even protest the environment. Don't let us point a finger at other continents such as Africa and South America, when we are culprits of doing the same in our own Pacific Northwest by cutting down redwood trees that have existed for 500 to 1,000 years. And why are we cutting them down? Because of our carelessness and our disposable society. Many of you are aware that the tuna is now being harvested without killing dolphins. Because we spoke up? Well, yes, but also because it hurt them in their pocketbook. They were not being sold. So they had to listen to us. The ivory trade, the government has done a wonderful job. But remember the black market, so don't buy even an old piece. Now the poachers have turned to the walrus and are slaughtering them for their ivory. Tortoiseshell, the sea turtle, has turned for the good. If you love animals, don't buy ivory or tortoiseshell. One drastic measure in Africa, the authorities are giving rhinos a safe anesthetic to remove the horns, which in fact, by the way, is only pressed air, to return them to the wild so they are no longer a desirable to the poachers for their horns. Perhaps your grandchildren will see rhinos in their time. Most of the beef produced for fast food chains is produced by cutting down the rainforest, which is killing the wild habitat. And once the beef has grazed on that land is lost forever. We are losing the oxygen, and we are even being poisoned by eating that meat. Where do the where do they pump most of the oil out of the desert? Where they have pumped most of the oil out of the desert, where the earth has changed, there once was plant and animal life was abundant. But today, we are changing the earth. It has been changed more in the past 50 years than the prior 1,000 years. Imagine the difference. In the last 50 years, we've done more change than we have in the whole 1,000 years prior to that. Because of our demands of disposable products, such as plastic. Thanks to the industry for eliminating such things as the pop can top that killed and maimed fish and birds. But however, please remember to cut up this small, the can holder. Many, many wild animals being found maimed because of this and dead. Injured beyond repair. So cut this up in small pieces. So easy for an animal to put his neck in. The plastic holds the sick bag. It has also proved to be a big killer of wildlife. Disposable trash, such as plastic bags, jars, cans, animals are found dead with their heads stuck in, unable to feed themselves. So crush your cans and use recycled paper. Take your paper bags back to the supermarket. Or buy a cotton cloth one and shop like we do in England. We do not use those kinds of things in England. We have our own shopping bags. We are opposed to rodeos. It's unkind to put a cinch strap around the horse's stomach and have a heavy man riding for so much given time while the poor horse is bucking, trying to get that cinch strap off. The roughest and the wilder ride, the cowboy gets higher points and often the horse gets tormented prior to the ride. You call that loving horses? And the poor bulls, what do they do to be treated like that? And as for calf roping, that is unforgivable, and thank goodness is outlawed in many states. Bullfighting, I certainly don't have to go into that, those kind of details. Greyhound racing, horse racing, fox hunting, cockfighting, and planned dog fighting. Circus performing animals, humans gratification, ego form of greed. You have been fortunate enough to see the animals that have been discussed. Wouldn't you like your children and your grandchildren to have the same opportunities you had? Environmental unsound practices will not be tolerated by the public in this country anymore. If we are destroying animals, we are destroying ourselves. We are not a transplanted being from another planet. We are created from this planet. You have a choice. Make an educated one. On June the 10th, you see I'm wearing a button, we are going to be marching for the animals in Washington, D.C. And can you imagine through the whole of Washington, when it's all quiet and those people are marching, there's going to be bells ringing. We have bells made especially for this occasion, with animals embossed all around them. And when you go up and sign your name, that you were there, and I want to be part of that history, and I am going, the wonderful thing is you can think of an animal that maybe you were not very kind to. Or maybe you could think of an animal that you loved so much, but you miss him or her. Or maybe you would just say, God help all the creatures that are still here. And ring that bell. Let that bell ring throughout the whole of Washington, D.C. on June 10th for the animals. Thank you.
Part of the we vision. Because remind people in case they don't remember. Because we're all we members. We're all this one big family we. We're all we ladies. It might sound a little silly or ridiculous, but it's important because we have to remind people. Otherwise, people just go about their way, their business, and they forget about the common bond that we all share. The first word then is the we, the whole earth, west and east. And as far as weecology is concerned, there's not ecology, it's weecology. It's the whole earth. We have to begin we using the things that we have. We have to recycle. It's recycling. We have to protect our natural resources. It's very important that we realize this because it's, earth is a living being, as we all talked about before. And if those of you who deny that it's living, raise your hand if you didn't feel those last earthquakes. It's alive and breathing. It's a living organism. And we have to respect it. It's our reward. We're responsible for it. Responsible for the planet. So the we goes along with the weecology. As far as weecology, there's one weecology. The whole world, the whole earth, eventually is going to have the same monetary system. In 1992 in Europe, they're going to have the European Common Market. Those of you familiar with this. They're going to have one monetary system all over Europe. Eventually, we're going to have a monetary system all over the country. I mean, the planet. It's going to be one country eventually. Because we have to start thinking in terms of we're building Toyotas, we're building Mercedes, we're building Fords, we're all one. We can't sit here and think of us, the Earth doesn't have any boundaries on here, this isn't any boundaries, it's just planets and water, that's all it is. We have to start evolving our consciousness, evolution, that's what evolution is all about. We have to evolve our consciousness. You talk about the 60s, those of us who were around in the 60s, there was a big push on, Uncle Sam wants you. That's not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. I mean, that's what you can do for your country. It's a you aside, we call it. We got past the you feeling. We all got into the me decade, the me generation. This is the ME, mass energy, we're all me. But the reflection of the me is the whole earth. This is the we generation. This is the we decade. More and more people, the whole planet is getting together. Look what's happening over in Europe, the west and east. Europe is getting together. Not from Russia, but they're joining together in a higher consciousness. They want to be part of the whole earth. That's what we're seeing happen. And that's what we're talking about as far as the economic situation. We have to have a we public of earth, the we United States. Everyone says, well, that won't work. Well, it works in the United States. We have separate individual states. Such will be the case in the planet. When we have a separate little country, we'll be we united as one regime, one we public of earth. And that's the Republic of Earth. That's as far as the political situation. We have the ecology, we have the economy, we have the republic, and finally we have the religion. We're all part of the religion of love. All of us, God is love. All of us are part of this religion. The separate religions are getting to the point where we realize we all have one common bond, one common unity. We all come from one. We're going to have a we formation. Resurrection, a we good. This is all, we'll have the we side will come. We'll all be that one individual. We'll all work together as one. So that's the first word we have to think about. And once again, one thing to do with the we is to weave to everybody. Everybody goes around weaving to each other and reminding people that we're all one. This whole thing is a we one. Everybody will remember this, right? Okay, the next word I want to share is love. Now, we talked a little bit about this earlier. But we all have to love, first of all, love ourselves, because we all are, each of us is part of each other. We're all loving one another. It's not so much loving what people do as loving the individual. Separate the sin from the sinner. You don't love what someone does, but you love them as an individual. Love the animals. You've got to love the animals. Love the trees. Love the sky. Love the fresh air. Love everything. That's one thing, like the song says, there's just too little love. There's always room for more love on this planet. Don't be ashamed to love. Some of us, we think we can love our spouses, our children, and our pets, whatever, but we can't love our neighbors, or we can't love other countries, or we can't love trees. It's foolish to love a tree, some people think, or love animals. So it's important to expand this consciousness. All of us have got to begin to love more and assume it, we're going to respect it. It's our responsibility. As you own something, you don't own anything. You might own your car, but you have to maintain it. You might say you own your house, and most of us are paying mortgages anyhow. All of us are, we think of ownership as something separate than responsibility. The responsibility comes in ownership. You have to think of something as ours and be responsible for it. So all of us have to kind of work together and realize that this is our planet. It doesn't belong to us, the United States. It belongs to the whole earth, rest in peace. So we all have to think in terms of our planet and what we can do to respect it, and our natural resources, our air, our water, all the water is being recycled, and all the air we breathe is spreads all the way around the planet. There's not any separation here. This is all ours. That brings us to the last concept, the feeling of home. The last word I want to share is home. Home is here on Mother Earth. All of us are home here. This is our planet. We all share the same mother. All of us came from the one Mother Earth, and all of us will eventually go back to it. All of our parts of our body are made up from Mother Earth. We all think of ourselves as separate individuals, but when you really think about it, we're all part of the consciousness here of Earth. We're all sharing a relationship. We're all part of one family. We're all related. And there's no way you can say that you're an alien from outer space or something. Let's face it, there's all a relationship that we all share. All of us are part of the family of man. And we all have one home here. We have to share this home together. And so what we want to do then is put all those four words together. We love our home. Because if we love our home, then we're going to respect it. We are going to cut down on our water usage. We are going to try and cut back on our addiction to automobiles. Let's face it, we're all addicted. I have one, and I'm sure most everyone in the room drives one every day. We don't have a whole lot of choice. But maybe we can come up with some alternative sources. Write our congressman. Do different things. Think about different things that we can be doing. Be more friendly. Be more open. Wave to people, give them the wee sign, remind them. You don't have to know somebody to say hello to them. All of us in this room, maybe next year, like you said, if we all bring five other people, there's a small group here, but at least we feel united, and it's important for all of us to have that consciousness. And we all have to work together as one family and share the love for the home that we have. That's the one common bond that we have. Because as I mentioned earlier, when we were passing this around, we don't have any place else to go. There isn't any alternatives. They're making a space station in a few years. Maybe we can go out and visit it or something. But as far as we're concerned, there's no choices. We have this one planet. We're all going to share it. We all have to love it. And we all have to work together to make this a very peaceful place. And it's all working together, and it's going to be harmonious. And I can see a lot of changes happening. Because even with nuclear power, for example, we're going to have nuclear vision. We're all going to be seeing things much clearer. Solar power, all these different alternatives are going to be happening. So there's a lot of chances for us and opportunities in the 90s. And this is going to be the wee generation and the wee decade. I want to thank all of you for being here tonight, too. And I think it's a good start. Joy, once again, did a great job here, too, organizing this. And we're going to get more and more people and reminding them that we're all one. And this is our home here on Mother Earth. Thank you a lot.
Ready for us that will be starting probably around 8:30, 8:40, somewhere in there. I just wanted to mention something to you. I was expecting a lot more people, I think we all were. And our expenses for tonight are approximately $500. And since I've been sponsoring it, this is going to have to come out of my hide somehow, unless, you know, if there's any of you out there that feel, you know, up to donating something to help us, we'd really appreciate it. So we can at least make expenses. This is a kickoff. What we're planning on doing is many different programs through my health food store, through the networking that we're doing with the with Jonathan, with June. June's going to be coming in with us, you know, in our store, and we're going to be expanding and growing and offering all kinds of community-wide programs. From working with strengthening the family to creation spirituality, which Larry and I are involved in, doing something here in Southern California. So we're going to need a lot of support, a lot of help, and right now some money also. So if there's any of you out there. Also, too, we have some raffles, some raffle gifts that have been donated by people within the community. Real Aloe Company has given us some cosmetics. We've got all kinds of, we've got a plant that's been donated by Green with Envy, by Tony back there. We've got, also June is going to offer a free grooming for a dog or coming into her obedience class for animals. So, and also I'm donating a free facelift. We have a machine in the store that does a facelift. It's a cumulative thing, so we're giving a free session. So, I don't know, Bob, is there anyone, are there any anyone who's bought raffle tickets back there? Oh, Mildred, you bought three tickets and it looks like you may end up with it all. So, what they are is 50 cents a piece or three for a dollar. So you can go back during the intermission and Bob will be glad to sell them to you. Also, two pictures all around here. They're Joy Art Gallery, which has nothing to do with me. He's next to me in Sycamore Plaza. But what he's gonna do is donate $10 out of every picture sold to our fund. We've also got other things that I know you've already been milling around. We have also up here Bradshaw Film Series, which is part of developing self-esteem. Joe Studer, I think, I've not got my glasses on, so I'm not sure if he's here, but we'll be having, during the intermission, you can sign up for classes and so forth that will be going on and ask Joe any questions you want to. Also, Carol Krugman, a friend of mine, we've both been involved with Bradshaw, so we'll be there. I'll be there on nutrition or whatever if anyone has any questions. June will be there talking about animals if there's anyone that has any questions. I know there were several people that were asking, saying that that was a concern for them, so they can talk to her individually. Okay, so we'll break now and people can go milling around again, and if there's any questions, the Voice of the Forest will be ready to go on in about 20 minutes. I'll tell you a little bit about them. They came together, I met them through a course that I'm involved in called A Course in Miracles that has lecture series down in Hollywood and in Santa Monica. They came together to be involved with the Rainforest. They're a wonderful, wonderful group of people. Their main drummer just got back from Brazil where he was working in the rainforest for 3 weeks. So they'll be a really great group. There are about 9 people in the group, and it would be neat to have another concert and have Psychedelic Juice and them just for the whole concert. I think you're really going to enjoy it, so be sure and stick around, okay? We'll see you after a bit.